Hey!
Welcome back, everyone, to another edition of
Live from Lavender Town.
Yeah, and this is part two of the last episode. So if you didn't watch the last episode, be sure to go and watch it. Basically, I'm doing a discussion on a recent event within our hobby and on the general state of the hobby as it exists. And I'd love to unpack this in more depth. I would love to actually have some more statistics, but basically we're going to open up some Sword and Shield product, but I want to continue this discussion where we talked about a bad streaming event and the fallout of that, and about the state of our hobby in general. And the streamer that was involved in that, Unlisted Leaf, has since said that he's stepping down from... He's quitting YouTube, you know, he's done. And I don't know, I mean, he could change his mind. He could, this could be a heat of the moment sort of thing, and he could be like, no, I don't really feel that way. The point is, like, there's a conversation that, like, definitely needs to be had about, like, power and exploitation, and about intention, and, like, how much does that matter, you know, all these different aspects of our hobby. Pokemon has blown up, and it's blown up for some amazing reasons. It's amazing. Pokemon is, it's just freaking amazing, and I love that it's like so spread itself. It's as a franchise. Before last year, when the TCG blew up, Pokemon had already for a long time been the highest grossing media franchise in history. I mean that, like, more than any other media franchise, more than Star Wars, you know, more than Lego, more than Marvel, Pokemon was bigger. Number two, interestingly, Hello Kitty.
Hello Kitty, I'm okay with that.
That's like perfect for Joanna. And number three is Winnie the Pooh. Just a random factoid for you. Wouldn't expect it. I think the number four is Marvel. But, ooh, nice, a reverse pound pad. Oh, you got Sableye. You can make that deck. It's really fun. You use Weezing to poison the opponent, and it puts four damage counters immediately. And then Sableye comes in and does 60 times each damage counter on your opponent's active Pokemon. So you just, like, wreck. It's super fun. And you have Inteleon on the bench sniping to get those damage counters out there. It's great. That's an awesome card to get. Yeah, it... I love that it's such a big media empire, and I love that it's reached into so many people's lives. But Pokemon is not perfect. The Pokemon community is not perfect. And there are conversations to be had about, you know, who we want to be as a community and what we want for our community. And it's fair to say that a lot of creators are disingenuous. And, hey, Kramit's really good actually with Spit Shot. Does 160 to the bench, or to any Pokemon, but like you can hit to the bench. People put that in a lot of decks. So it's good to have a copy of. It's fair to say that there are a lot of creators that are just, they don't have the best of intentions, and they're clearly exploiting the popularity of the TCG especially in order to grift money. And I don't think, at least for the most part, I don't think that Unlisted Leaf and Leon Hart and some of those figures fit in that spectrum. I don't. I think there are far more blatant actors who are making this into a grift. I know, like, Leonhardt had a gift box thingy with, like, custom cards and stuff on it. When I, like, look at the price of that, and I try to, like, really, like, look at, okay, what are these people really doing? How are they really making money, right? Because no matter how nice they can seem on the outside, that doesn't mean they're nice people or that they're entirely honest. But, like, I don't see anything really nefarious at all in anything that Leonhardt has done. on his channel. And you could, you might roll your eyes at his videos and not really enjoy them, and that's fine. But the idea that he's a bad actor and is like a grifter, and this is all a game to him to make money, like, I just don't buy it. I think he really does love Pokemon. I really do. I mean, I do also think that he, you know, needs to make money. Like, that's, like, I'm not saying that he would be doing this for free because his money would run out and he'd have to do something else. And sure, when you acquire power and money, like, you can lose sight of things. I think Unlisted Leaf is a great example of that because he's somebody who I also believe genuinely, genuinely loves Pokemon. But, hey, Celebi! And this Chinchino is really good. You can discard and draw two cards. Really good in decks. I do think that over time, despite the fact that I do believe he really loves Pokemon, as he's gotten and acquired more wealth from being a PokeTuber and streaming, or not streaming, but, you know, making videos for YouTube, uploading them, of him opening up packs and things, at a certain point you become disconnected, and there's no question that people who do are, like, in a position where, without meaning to, maybe, you know, to some extent looking the other way, they can exploit their audiences. And again, whether that's intentional or not, it's really easy to do and to not think twice about it when you're in that position. And that doesn't make it okay. It doesn't, and it's absolutely okay to want to hold those people accountable. I think that's totally, like, no matter what, if I ever had power in any capacity, I would try to be as, ooh, man, you are pulling every single V left, right, and center, except the two legendary dogs. Soon. Absolutely, I would want people to be holding me accountable, and I would want to hold myself accountable, but I also recognize how dangerous that is, and how you need people around you to check you, and to, like, make you aware of the power you have, and, like, the damage you could do, whether you meant to or not, you know? That's a fair criticism to make about some of these people. But I genuinely don't believe that there's a comparison to be made between Unlisted Leaf and Leonhard and some of those people and some of these grifters that are, like, very shamelessly just in it for the money. And the scalping epidemic, the break epidemic, it's a huge problem. It's a huge, huge problem within our hobby. It inflates the value of the cards. It makes people do horrible things to one another. It, like, is used to exploit people for money. No matter how much you try to make your videos for adults on this format, kids are gonna view them. They're gonna view them on TikTok, they're gonna view them on Instagram, they're gonna view them on YouTube, they're gonna view them wherever they can get their hands on them. And they're going to be giving you money out of their wallet that they don't, or their parents' money, that they don't fully comprehend the value of what they're doing, and they're gonna form parasocial relationships with you and think that they're forming a bond and that doing the break is, like, a good deal. It's a good opportunity to have their moment of you saying their name or whatever. And, man, you need to be really careful with that. And almost nobody is. To one extent or another. I can tell some actors, you know, definitely try to. I think Deerium tries to be careful with that. I still think that his prices are too much. But he at least tries to take care of the people that buy his product, and he'll, like, give them bonus stuff if they don't get good pulls on his breaks. Like, I think there are others that are a lot worse. I think the entire industry in and of itself, it's a little bit broken. And I'm, that's me saying that, like, I'm mentioning Deerium, like, I'm not trying to smear his name at all. I'm actually saying he's the closest to acceptable in that. You know, I like watching his videos. I believe that he really means well. Oh my god! You got a second gold quick ball, Joanna! are you kidding me? And she died. Oh, Lord, she did.
Oh, Lord, she died.
What do you think about that, Bobby?
What do you think about that, Evie?
If I'm mentioning somebody by name, Leonhart, Unlisted Leaf, or Dirium, I'm doing so because even if I don't think they're perfect, I think that they genuinely have good intentions, and I think that they are more of a net good for the Pokemon trading card game and the Pokemon brand in general than a net bad. Like, I sincerely, sincerely believe that. These are people whose videos I've been watching for a long, long time. I really love them. They've, like, helped me to engage with and enjoy the Pokemon trading card game in a way that I otherwise couldn't, because I can't afford to buy tons and tons of these packs. I mean, yeah, online packs, I'm opening them up a lot. We're opening them up a lot. But, like, and we've been opening more physical stuff, but we're not rich. We can't afford to buy them. And if I had a lot of money, I would want to invest it in other ways. I would love to open Pokemon with some of it, but a lot of it I would want to do far more... I'd want to do far more socially responsible things with it. I'd also want to find that kid from my street who got me to trade away my first edition Charizard, and I would get that sucker back.
At that person.
Yes. You know where you are, Kyle. I would buy it from him, but I, you know, like, it's fair and square. I traded it to him, you know, although it's still, like, it was a sucky deal. I didn't get holographics, okay? But the point is, like, I love, like, warts and all, I think that there are a lot of really well-meaning people who have done a lot of good for the community. But there are a lot of people who have not. And I'm not going to name them, and I didn't name them in the last video either, because... I'm not a call-out channel. This isn't a drama TV channel. Nice. Get that Frostmoth. Can't you get that gold quick ball? That's not what this is. And I don't need to be stirring up beef with people. So, lest it be misconstrued otherwise, the names that I've brought up thus far, I genuinely appreciate them. I think that they're good for the community. But I think that the people who are imitating Dirium and doing their breaks are doing them in a lot more exploitative ways often, and are often not as much in love with Pokemon as Dirium and his team is. And I think the same is true, you know, I think Ando and Leonhart, I think they both genuinely love Pokemon. I don't think there's an argument to be made there. Besides the fact that there are a lot of toxic actors who don't love Pokemon that are exploiting, there are a lot of toxic actors within our community who buy Pokemon products and who aren't like these big name people. Like, what, we have like a handful of viewers on our channel every video, and I'm super grateful for them, but I'm not those people, you know, and I'm completely fine with that because this is just fun to do. It's just fun to put this out in the world, even if not many people ever end up seeing it. The thing is, we, as those of us who are not the Poke celebrities, like, we have toxic patterns too. We sometimes don't do a very good job welcoming in newer people into the Pokemon trading card game, showing them the ropes. We are super negative a lot. And when I watch PTCG Radio, who is another one of my favorite Pokemon YouTubers, I adore PTCG Radio. I adore what Ross is doing. That is an awesome card to get too. You're getting all these staples. He will go out of his way to try to find the best in every card that he looks at. And I mean, he's not unrealistic, like, every single card is the best card ever, but he's like, hey, this is a good card. I could see how this could be playable in a certain scenario. If the few cards where he's like, this is not a good card, those are really bad cards, and it's like, why did Pokemon make that card? They shouldn't have made that card, you know? But he does a really good job explaining where those cards fit within the Pokemon format, you know? And how many of these... Oh, this is your first reverse. Like, that's super valuable, and there are a lot of people who come into the comments and are just like, how dare you say such and such card is good? All the cards are bad except for these three cards. I mean, I went into the card shop after Evolving Skies dropped, and a dude had pulled an alt art Rayquaza VMAX, the most valuable card in the set, and was like, yeah, I'm just trying to get rid of it. I'm just trying to trade it. It's not a good card. How is it not a good card? It's super rare, and people really love looking at it, even if you don't play the games at all. And Rayquaza VMAX is not a bad card. It is not, you know, dominating the meta by any means, but it's not a bad card. It just factually isn't. If it's a bad card, 90% of Pokemon cards are bad cards. And why are you then playing a game where 90% of the things that are printed are worthless? I just can't see that. Obviously, there are some cards that dominate the format. Obviously, there are some cards that are better than others, but this, like, super negative mentality is just... it's yuck, man. If I was a brand new player on the outside looking in, I don't want to get in on this when I hear people say that about, like, what if I just pulled my... I did just pull a Rayquaza VMAX. I was excited about it. It's, like, kind of, like, annoying. Like, come on, man. Like, we could stand to be more positive. When I looked at the comments regarding the Unlisted Leaf situation, there were a lot of people who were rightfully upset, you know, about how exploitative it was, and rightfully upset at Ando, and feeling like he needed to make it right. And I agreed with them. But there were also a ton of people who were just so toxic, and were so like, Leonhard and Ando and Dirium and all these people are horrible for the game, they're awful for the Pokemon trading card game, and they all need to go away, and good riddance, and like, I hope he does go through with taking his, like, horrible things to say about people. Horrible, horrible things. And I can't see how you would look at those people who are the least bad actors in a game that's just rife with bad actors, and point to the people who are the least exploitative, even if you could make an argument that some of the things they do might be, and say those are the people that are what's wrong with the game, not the toxic communities that are popping up and just spreading all this grossness, not all the scalpers and grifters. Like, God, at the very least, I can, for free, and I've never given Ando, or Dirium, or Leonhart, or sadly, even PTCG Radio, I really oughta. I've never given them a cent of my money. I've never done anything. Yo, get you that Rainbow Rare! Look at that! It's Bead. Beady? Bead? I always say Bead. Aw, Eevee's excited. Bede. I've never given them a cent of my money. I've consumed tons and tons of their content for free, and I give their content likes and views, but ultimately, like, I gain more from those relationships than they ever have gained from me. That's just a fact. So, for me to say that they are the bad guy, I don't know how anybody then becomes the good guy. It feels disingenuous at best. There's a lot that we all need to work on. There's a lot that the more influential people, like, there are a lot of things that need to change about the trading card game and about the Pokemon, like, brand in general. I don't want to focus on the few that are, I think, providing more positive than negative, and, like, hold a microscope to the flaws and say, this is where the worst of the worst is, completely ignoring the cesspool around that, you know? That just seems absurd to me. And that's my whole piece in this two-part thing. That's my whole spiel about this. I had opinions, and I put them out there for however few people end up watching this. And we're down to the last pack. What you gonna get? Are you finally gonna get sassy in? How many have you got?
Two.
I've got some for you, don't worry. But, let's be a sassy in anyway, huh? I'm sorry. How do you feel about that, Eevee?
Yeah.
Aww.
Sad too.
I'm sad too, Eevee. I'm sad about the state of the game. But you know what? I'm never gonna stop loving Pokemon.
Me neither.
It's given me so much joy in my life, and I hope that I've been able to share a piece of that with anybody that watches these videos. I think Joanna feels the same. Mm-hmm. And we're going to go ahead and just return you to your regularly scheduled content. And we'll see you all next time on another edition of...
Live from Lavender Town.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
Bye.